If you look on the histology of testes, so first of all, testes are covered by a thick connective tissue capsule, thick connective tissue, which is actually dense in regular connective tissue, which is actually dense in regular connective tissue. This dense in regular connective tissue is known as what? Tunica albuginea. This is known as tunica albuginea. This tunica albuginea do two things in the formation of testis structure. Number one, they invade inside and make septa. They invade inside and make septa. Okay, with this septa, we will have testicular lobes. We will have testicular, this dense in regular connective tissue. And also, this capsule extend here and make a area. This area is known as tunica extension of tunica albuginea from the posterior side. This area will be known as mediastinum testis. Okay, this will be area, this area R will be known as what? Lobes of testis here are lobular testis. Okay, these are different lobes. If you look inside these lobes, you will find they have what? What really happening? Focus here again carefully. First of all, the structural component of the testis is tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea is a dense in regular connective tissue, okay, which invade in the parenchyma, make septa, make septas, and convert this testis into the different lobes. Convert this testis into the and other side, they also make an area which have many ducts. This area is known as mediastinum testis. Okay, what really happening here? In some cases, in some animals, this dense irregular connective tissue you can find down here and other layer of rich with blood vessels, which rich with blood vessels, which also invade into the septum. This septa is incomplete, so this area also known as tunica vasculasa or vascular, that's mean blood vessels. Okay, so we have beneath the tunica albuginea, tunica vasculosa means have blood vessels or lymph vessels. What really happening here? If you want to really understand mediastinum, we need our other diagram to make it more clear sometime. For example, if this is the testis, so this area is middle is the mediastinum testis. From here we have what? Septa. So this is in the middle of testis. Is many animals have such kind of arrangement. So here for this diagram, this outer line is what? Tunica albuginea. Here if an other line, okay, what is this? Tunica vasculosa. Okay, this entry inside is what? Septa, complete septa. This middle area is mediastinum. These are the areas remaining because of the incomplete septa. These are known as what? Lobes. These are lobe. It's clear. If you explore these lobes, you will find what? You will find here you have a colloid ducts. So these colloid ducts are known as what? And these colloid ducts are actually embedded into the interstitial tissue. Embedded into the, that's mean around this colloid seminiferable tubules, we have what? Interstitial tissue. Around these tubules, we have what? Interstitial tissue. So these structures are known as, these tubes are known as semi-tubules, okay? And around seminiferable tubules, we have what? Interstitial tissue, okay? What really happening? These seminiferable tubules continue to form a single straight duct. Continue to form a single straight duct. This single straight duct is normally, you know, this known as straight duct, known as, but sometime it's also called as duct recti. As for example, here if we have some what? Collide seminiferable tubules, then they have a straight duct. Around this we have what? Seminiferable interstitial tissue. So this is known as straight duct or duct recti. Clear? So these straight tubules togetherly form a what? A network of, yes, a network of tubules. They are joined together. So this network of tubules, for example, if we have here, so they will form a network of tubules, okay? So this network will be known as retitestis, known as RET, retitestis, clear? So this retitestis actually further joined into with what? This whole area is will be, this is mediastinum, so this whole area is covered with what? Retitestis. So this retitestis further connected with to a ductalis afferent. Ductalis afferents. This ductalis afferent joined into a large duct which we called epididymis, okay, which we called as epididymis. For example, here this retitestis will be connected with duct afferent, and then we have what? Epididymis. So here we have what? Epididymis. So this epididymis further joined with what? Vas deferens or duct deferens, or, you know why I'm putting a lot of stress on this? Because you need to understand two things very clearly. Structurally, testes are a network of tubes. Structurally, testes are a network of tubules. For example, we have two types of tubules here. If you want to know it, one is we can call as intratesticular ducts or tubules, okay, and other one is extratesticular ducts. If you are looking for intratesticular ducts, we have what? Seminiferable tubules. Then we have duct recti or straight tubule. Then we have retitestis, then we have afferent tubule. After this, these are the extra testicular tubules. Maybe afferent is also coming extra. Which one? Epididymis, vas deferens. These are known as extra testicular. You know what really happening here? The spermatozoa or sperm produce in seminiferable tubules, store in epididymis, and during the ejaculation via vas deferens release or go out from the body. Listen again carefully. Spermatozoa produce where? In spermatogenesis, in seminiferable tubules via duct reti and retitestis. Come into the epididymis, store there and also do some maturation. After maturation, और ड्यूरिंग एजाकुलेशन वाया वास डिफरेंस दिस कम आउट फ्रॉम द बॉडी. दैट्स क्लियर. नो वी विल लुक इनटू मोर डिटेल इनटू द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ टेस्टिस. दिस जस्ट अप टू हियर यू जस्ट नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस होल टेस्टिस इज कवर्ड बाय अ कनेक्टिव टिश्यू कैप्सूल हैविंग ब्लड सप्लाई हैविंग नर्व सप्लाई हैविंग लिम्फ सप्लाई एंड दिस whole thick connective tissue capsule actually enclose a network of tubules. It's clear. Now we will look into the detail of that tubules, how they perform the function and what kind of epithelium, what kind of cell they have. Clear? Okay. So we need a one diagram. First of all, if we take a section from here of micro to understand this, we will form, if this the upper one, this upper one is what? Tunica albuginea connective tissue. The lower one is what? So this tunica albuginea is invaginate. Okay, inside they have blood vessels or some things like this structure. Here on the cross section you will find what? This round structure, okay, like this under microscope. Okay, what really happening here? These are two different lobes. For example, we have a section from here, okay, so you will find what? These are the seminiferable tubules. These are the seminiferable tubules. Each tubule has its own lumen. Each tubule has its own lumen. Around this, you have what? You have interstitial tissue. So there is the 2 to 3 types of cell population which you need to understand. These tubes actually, they have what? If you are talking about seminiferable tubules, this lining may be basement membrane. Okay, let's leave it just. First, you look, we will find here two kind of cell. We will find here two kind of cell if you are looking on microscope. These two kind of cells are of germ cell, which is means spermatogonia, and we have sporting cell inside the tubes. Okay, inside the tubes, we have two type of cells. Which one? Spermatogonia or germ cell, and a sporting cell which we call Sertoli cell, which we call Sertoli cell. Outside of these tubules, outside of these tubules, we have one type of cell which is an interstitial type of cells, which we call as this cell here. For example, we have a cell. Okay, so this cell will be known as Leydig cells. We also have blood vessels around here on the interstitial area. So these cells are known as leading cells. This is known as leading cells. So point is that, listen again carefully. If you are looking on the microscopic section of this area of the testis, you will find some of the basic things. Definitely we have tunica albuginea. That's mean dense irregular connective tissue capsule. There is down we have a lining of blood vessels, that means tunica vesiculosa. Inside septa, which is converting to testis into lobes, we have what? We have seminiferable tubules and interstitial tissue. In seminiferable tubules we have what? Two kind of cells, which are germ cell and Sertoli cell. Outside we have leading cells. It's clear? Okay. Now if you explore a single, we are going into the more higher magnification. If you explore a single seminiferable tubules, you will find what? Okay, if you are exploring this, for example, a single seminiferable tubules here, okay, you will find what? You will find definitely this tubules like this. For example, they have definitely the lining epithelium. दिस लाइनिंग एपिथीलियम विच बी यू कैन कॉल्ड हेयर जर्मिनल एपिथीलियम, यू विल बी कॉल्ड हेयर जर्मिनल एपिथीलियम एंड अदर सेंस टेक्निकली दिस एपिथीलियम इज स्ट्रेटिफाइड एपिथीलियम. दिस एपिथीलियम इज बिकॉज दिस एपिथीलियम हैव मैनी लाइनिंग्स, दिस एपिथीलियम हैव नॉट अ सिंगल लाइन. So first of all, this round seminiferable tubule, this black line make it as basement membrane. This black line is basement membrane. Okay, always you know epithelial cells are lies on basement membrane. So it's understanding on side of this we have what? Interstitial tissue. This is here we have outside interstitial tissue. So this is a basement membrane. You know, if you look on interstitial tissue first, you will have what? You may be find some connective tissue cells. What? You know, fibroblast. Yes. You know, myoid cells. You can find, but outside of the base, remember, outside of the basement membrane, a cell which people do not discuss too much, which is known as telocytes. You will not find the name of this cell in any book, telocytes. This is a new discovery, still not in, quoted in any book. Point is that this is also interstitial cells. So out of this tube we have interstitium. So we have fibroblast, myocyte, telocytes, but functionally most important we have leading cell. We have leading cells. We have leading cells. Okay, fibroblast, myocytes and telocytes. And the blood vessels. Here, the demarcation is what? This is what? Black lining? Basement? If you look inside the basement membrane, on basement membrane, definitely we have what? Epithelial cells. So, the epithelium is here is the germinal epithelium. The reason of this name is that because they have germ cells. The other, they're also known as stratified epithelium. Stratified is because they have many linings of cells. They have many linings of cells. So if you look here, you will find we are looking a higher magnification. So we will find two kind of cell here. One is the germ cell and one is the sportive cells. The germ cells will be spermatogonia. Germ cell will be the spermatogonia. Spermatogonia have two types. Spermatogonia have, look, let's first draw what? Let's first draw Sertoli cell, because Sertoli cells are large cell. They are all the large cell. They are the large cells. Okay. And I can tell you very interesting thing here. You know a term which we called as blood testis barrier. Blood testis. You know what really happening? These large cells are what? Sertoli cell. Yeah, they have well defined nucleus. They have well defined. Between these cells, even in the ridges of these cells, we have a population of cell which we called as spermatogonia, which we called as spermatogonia. It's clear. We need to understand one thing very clearly. These the lateral border of two Sertoli cells. They joins together. For example, here is if the cell, they joins together like this. They make here what? Tight junctions. They make here what? Tight junctions. This lateral border is here, for example. We are not making all, but few to understand this. They joins together a group of oclodin proteins. So they are making what? Tight junctions. They are making what? This is something very important, my dear student. Give focus on this. Okay. So they are making, point is that, look here again carefully, because this tight junctions, we have two areas here, we have to, if this is a junction, the area up from these junctions, which we, you will find what, which cell? Spermatogonia. So this area is known as basal region of seminiferable tubules. This area will be known as this basal region of seminiferable tubules. This, you know, this we are already understanding, this middle part is the lumen. This middle part is the lumen. So this area, if the, here is this basal region, this remaining region will be known as the area of next to the tight junction. Area next to the tight junction will be known as, this area will be known as adluminal. Luminal mean lumen. Adluminal region of seminiferable tubules. Listen again carefully. These things you need to understand very well. A seminiferable tubules have two kind of cell population, Sertoli cells and germ cell. Okay. These Sertoli cell, the lateral border make a tight junction. They make a tight junction and divide this tubes into two regions. The region above, which is near to the basement membrane, will be known as basal region, which be known as, and next to the tight junction, which is toward the lumen, which is the toward the lumen. So this area will be known as adluminal region. So this is in the middle is junction. Okay, from junction to upside toward the basement side is which area? Basal area. And two, from junction toward the lumen side is adluminal region. So what really happening here? Because of these junctions, tight junctions, because every Sertoli cell lateral border, every Sertoli cell lateral border have a junction with two other Sertoli cell lateral border. So that's mean we are making a barrier here. That's mean we are making a tight junction, mean anything cannot pass on. So we are making a barrier here. So this barrier is known as what? Blood testis barrier, BTB. Blood testis barrier. This blood testis barrier have very functional importance. That's why I'm putting a lot of stress here. Look again carefully on the diagram. We have what? We have basal region and adluminal regions. Between these two regions, we have a barrier which is known as? How this barrier is forming here? Because the lateral border of each Sertoli cells making a junction between other Sertoli cell lateral border by the help of some protein, oclodin protein for example, they are making what? Tight junction. So every lateral border have a tight junction. So that's mean in that area we have a barrier which is known as? Why I am putting a lot of stress here? Because in this adluminal region and lumen, okay, two things we have. There is the going, the production of sperm. The area there is the sperm is developing. The area which is sperm is? So this area need a sophisticated environment. Because blood is coming from here, okay. This barrier will be prevent blood to go into the lumen. This barrier will be prevent blood go into the lumen. So that's why this is called blood testis barrier. Why we need a prevention? Why we need a blood do not come into the lumen? The number one reason is that if there is any antigen and any bacteria, anything in the blood, it will not go into the lumen and will not damage the development of sperm. Point number two. If there is, because this is something is developing, new thing is developing inside lumen. So we also want our immune system do not interfere. We also want, if maybe a immune system can detect, oh, something is new. The duty of immune system, any foreign party or something new in the body, he will detect and attack. So we want here, because here is the development of sperm is going on. So do not a single interference by immune system, not an interference by any foreign body, not interference of any foreign body. So blood from the interstitium come into here, but stay up to the blood testis barrier. It means stay up to basal region. Stay up to basal regions. It's clear. Reason is that we do not want to interfere the development of the spermatozoa. It's clear. So that is the blood testis barrier thing you must remember. Point number two, what really happening? Now we will look into how the spermatozoa or this germ cells will be converted into spermatozoa. Okay? For this, very simple. You know what is, if somebody asks you, please define spermatogenesis, how you will define, Mr. Ali? Maryam, Akram, again please.
The maturation of spermatids into
anybody else want to define what is the spermatogenesis? One, please raise your hand.
Meiosis of spermatogenesis.
Inam. You know, spermatogenesis is a very special procedure of the body. Which one? Spermatogenesis. You know, the easiest definition of spermatogenesis is the formation of male gamete. Formation of? Or the formation of spermatozoa. This is a one-liner definition of spermatogenesis. But let me tell you, this is not a simple. Spermatogenesis is a very complex and the sophisticated procedure we have. If outside on the basement we have what? Germ cell. We have germ cell in basal region, okay? And they are the large cells, Sertoli cells. They are from basal to the lumen, up to the lumen. What really happening during spermatogenesis, this germ cell will be divide and change their structure. Change their structure, give new cells. So at the end of the result, you have what? Sperm, spermatozoa. You will have. So this procedure need two things. Number one, they need a great order by the influence of the hormones. They need hormones who will direct these cells to divide. To differentiate. And other thing is that this structure, this cell will change their structure, until to reach to the final spermatozoa. So, first of all, if you want to look how hormone act on this procedure, so, you know what, the spermatogenesis in the male start at the puberty, and it's believed that in 1 second a human can produce 1,000 sperm. A human can produce 1,000 sperm in 1 second after puberty. In single ejaculation, animals have millions of sperms. What really happening here? You know hypothalamus? Hypothalamus. Down hypothalamus you have what? Pituitary gland. What really happening here? Listen again carefully. This hypothalamus will produce a hormone which is we call that GnRH. What is this? Yes, gonadotropin releasing hormone. You know, this hormone do what? This will go into the pituitary gland and ask to release two hormones. These two hormones is LH and FSH. LH luteinizing hormone, FSH follicle stimulating hormone. This LH will be go on the interstitium of testis. He will find receptor on the leading cell. He will find receptor on the leading cells, Okay, LH is coming here. So this receptor will pick luteinizing hormone. So this luteinizing hormone will order to leading cell produce testosterone. The one of the function of leading cell to produce. So they will produce testosterone. And follicle stimulating hormones. They will come on seminiferable tubules and interact and direct to the Sertoli cell. Direct to the Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells will be produced ABP. ABP full form is androgen binding protein. Androgen binding effector will be produced by Sertoli cell. Have so many functions. We are giving on the importance only one. They are producing ABP, androgen binding protein. So actually these two hormones, these two structures, this, the role of ABP is they will increase the concentration, they will increase the binding of testosterone inside the seminiferable tubules. So these two hormones, actually testosterone will direct to the seminiferable tubules to perform spermatogenesis. Testosterone will maintain spermatogenesis. Testosterone will be maintained or ordered to the seminiferable tubules to perform spermatogenesis. And this agent, which we are calling ABP, this will increase the concentration of the testosterone inside the seminiferable tubules, inside the ST, seminiferable tubules. Listen again carefully. Here we have GnRHR, which is we known as gonadotropin hormones. This will act on pituitary gland. Pituitary gland will be released luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. This LH will be go on to the leading cell, order him to the release testosterone. This testosterone order to the seminiferable tubules, please perform spermatogenesis. So this FSH go on to the seminiferable tubules and order to the Sertoli cell, please produce ABP. This ABP will increase the concentration and binding capability of testosterone in the seminiferable tubule. So if the concentration of testosterone is maintained in the seminiferable tubules, spermatogenesis is going on continuously, because the required level of hormone is maintained here inside the seminiferable tubules. It's clear.
Yes,
what really happening here? How this round spermatogonia convert into the spermatozoa? This whole procedure in which a single cell, germ cell, convert into the spermatozoa, different type of cell, is known as spermatogenesis. What really happening? We have two kind of spermatogonia. We have what? Did you remember the names? Please recall. Type A, type B. No. First of all, this we have what? This germ cell in male is known as? So, my dear student, there is two types. Step number one, which we call spermatogonia type A dark spermatogonia, DARK. This one is the pale type A spermatogonia. Listen again carefully. Here the population of spermatogonia is two types. We have two types of spermatogonia. Type A dark spermatogonia, type A pale spermatogonia. Okay, there will be mitosis now. So this dark cell will give us back a dark cell. So if this pale cell will be produced in two cells, so this will give us our sp- spermatogone type B cell spermatogonia, or and also a pale cell type A. What really happening? This is the already present germ cell on the basement membrane, okay, type A dark cell, okay. This pale type A cell will do some what? Division. They will do some mitosis and will give us pale type A and B type spermatogonia. Which type? B type spermatogonia. This type A pale will go back and maintain the population on the basement membrane. But this type B will further divide. This B type spermatogonia, which B type spermatogonia divide and give us what? This B type spermatogonia divide and give us a big cell, you know, a big cell with a well defined nucleus. This cell is actually known as primary spermatocyte. This cell is known as primary spermatocytes. Listen again carefully. There we have a population of germ cell type A dark, type A pale. Okay. So this will, the one of them will maintain the population. One will be go divide into type B spermatogonia. This type B spermatogonia, with the help of mitosis, will be converted into primary spermatocytes. This primary spermatocytes definitely will be divided into what? Primary spermatocyte divide into what? I will tell you. There is no polar body, man. This is a spermatogenesis. So this primary spermatocyte will be converted into secondary spermatocytes. Okay, we have two more cells here. Okay, the size of cell is going to decrease. Look, listen here again carefully. Here, start from here. Pale will be give us type B spermatogonia. Normal division is going on here. One cell will be go back and maintain the population. Other will go in the further division and they will give us primary. And other division here, we will have, actually this, here you have meiosis 1. This is a meiosis 1. Primary spermatocyte convert into secondary spermatocyte with the help of
meiosis 1.
Next you will have what? No, man, meiosis 2. What happened to your basic knowledge?
Yes,
this is the only place in your body where is meiosis is occurring.
Yes, sir.
This is the only place in your body where is the meiosis occurring. So start from here. Here is mitosis. This is here B type spermatogonia with the help of mitosis. Mitosis will be converted into and other sense. If this is here, listen again carefully. This is the what? B type spermatogonia. So this will definitely have 46 chromosomes. Because you have here what?
Mitosis.
Here we have mitosis. So the number of the chromosomes will remain same. Clear? Here, after primary spermatocyte, after there will be what? Meiosis. Here, how much we have? You all are wrong. Think again. Yes. What really happening in meiosis 1? You know, there is some basic system, procedure like crossing over. You know this? So these mechanisms which are associated with meiosis one, they are occurring here. In secondary spermatocytes, the number of chromosome will be half. So we have here. What happening next? Meiosis two. Okay. What is meiosis two actually? Meiosis two. In meiosis two, you will have what? Two cells from here joint each other, actually these two cells. Okay, two from here, definitely two from here. So these cells are known as what? Spermatids. You know this nomenclature, you need to understand. Okay, here we have spermatogonia B type spermatogonia. Okay, mitosis, they converted into this. Now this is a sequence, primary spermatocytes. This primary spermatocytes, then definitely we have one spermatogonia, two primary spermatocyte here. So these two will be converted into four, okay, with the help of mitosis. But the resultant cell will be known as yes, the nomenclature is pointed. This is secondary spermatocytes. This will convert into, with the help of second meiosis, with the help of second meiosis, you will have things you need to understand. If you are looking into the microscopic slide of testis, you may find all these stages of cell inside seminiferable tubules. You may find all these cells, okay, you have to identify, oh, this is a primary spermatocyte, this is a secondary spermatocyte, this is a spermatid, okay, this is a type A spermatogonia, this is a type B spermatogonia. So, before break, we are actually looking into the spermatogenesis. Up to now, we have understand some basic things. These cells, the first step is, the first phase is what? This is actually differentiation. This is the differentiation. These germ cells are differentiated into spermatogonia, B-type spermatogonia. The next phase is the cell division. First one is the mitosis. In the result of mitosis, we have primary spermatocytes from B spermatogonia. Then we have meiosis. Then we have second phase of spermatogenesis, in which we have secondary spermatocyte from primary spermatocytes. So, and the end result actually of the second phase of meiosis, finally we have what? Spermatids. Okay? What really happened after this, you know? This, from this, there will be no more cell division. There will be no? This cell, which you are calling spermatid, this will differentiate or take a special shape. This will take a special structure. A cellular procedure, which is actually another name, you called as spermiogenesis. You called as spermiogenesis, actually is the third phase of spermatogenesis. You are getting me? This, the whole procedure is known as the third phase of spermatogenesis is what? Spermiogenesis. So what really happening in third phase? In third phase, this spermatid will be converted into spermatozoa or take a definitely shape. For example, if we make this, for example, what is spermatid? Spermatid, a round cell, is a round cell. Okay, each spermatid actually attached with another spermatid, a structure they are sharing, which is called cytoplasmic bridge. why they are communicating each other at the early stage. Okay. Generally, what is a spermiogenesis? Spermiogenesis, this spermatid will be converted into the spermatozoa shaped like this, you know, the basic knowledge if you have. So, this will be converted into the, what really happening here? There are so many activities happening here. There is the condensation of the nucleus is happening here. Formation of acrosome is happening here. There is the withdrawal of some cell organelles here. You know what? If this is a spermatozoa, up here it will have what? Acrosome, very good. Here it will be have head, okay? Up to here, this is the hole is known as? Tail, okay? And here, middle, we have a mid piece, you know this term? In this area you have what? Mitochondria. So what really happening here? This spermatid is converting into the spermatozoa. This spermiogenesis is actually a cell differentiation procedure which are converting a round shaped spermatozoa, spermatid into a elongated shape spermatozoa. In the spermiogenesis, a round shaped spermatid it converting into the elongated spermatozoa. In this conversion, we have lot of reaction is occurring here, lot of cellular changes actually occurring here. What is happening? Lot of cellular changes is happening here. Number one, there is, you know, if this is the spermatozoa, I have a lot of area of cytoplasm. Here we have less cytoplasm. There is the reduction of cytoplasm. Here we have every organelles. For example, ribosomes. For example, endoplasm, reticulum, mitochondria. But here we have predominantly mitochondria. Other, organelles are vanished. Next, we have a special structure on top of the head of this structure. We also have a tail or flagellum. This is what we call cell differentiation from unspecialized cell to a specialized cell. All these structures are the requirement of spermatozoa to perform their functions. Come here. Here, this is what? This is seminiferable tubules. This is? So here is spermatogenesis going on. In the end, in the lumen, you will have what? Lot of spermatozoa, definitely. You will have lot of spermatozoa. So if you're looking on the microscope, the cross section of seminiferable tubules, you will find what? On basement membrane, spermatogonia. Next to spermatogonia, if you are on electron microscope, you will find tight junctions or blood test barrier. Next, you will find here primary spermatocyte, spermatid. In the lumen, spermatozoa. So at the same time, you can view all different cellular stage of spermatogenesis in seminiferable tubules. If the animal is a breeder and breeding is going on, he's producing sperms. Is clear? So look, that order is also like this. On the top, on the basement membrane, you will find what? Germ cells, which will give spermatogonia. Next you will find B-type spermatogonia, or you will find primary spermatocyte. Next you will find then spermatozoa. So this all kind of structure you will find in the seminiferable. You know why we need this spermatozoa to take such kind of structure? Because this spermatozoa have to travel lot of a long journey he have, like you people have when you are chasing some girls. So this journey is long in the search of ova, in the search of
ova.
Definitely this develop here, where in lumen, from lumen this will definitely go to where, straight tubule. From straight tubule it will go into ratty testis. From ratty testis it will be go into afferent duct. From afferent duct it will go to in epididymis. This spermatozoa will be stay, because at that stage he needs some maturation. It need some maturation, and the epididymis is actually the organ for storage. Actually the organ for the storage. You know, if you go back here, if you look on Sertoli cells, Sertoli cells is also called nursing cell or nurse cell. There are two reasons why they are known as the nursing cell, because they are making blood-brain barrier. They are making blood-brain making a barrier is actually making by Sertoli, not blood, testis, blood testis barrier. Sorry, blood testis barrier is making which cell? Sertoli cell, blood, BTB. So it's okay with the making of this barrier. They are protecting primary spermatocytes, secondary spermatocytes, spermatozoa. But at the same time, these cells need nutrition. If there is not blood is coming, that means there is no
nutrition
is coming. So these Sertoli cells also protecting this, also producing ABP to maintain spermatogenesis, but they are also providing nutrition to the developing cells. They are also providing to the nutrition to the developing cells. So that's why they are also known as sustandicular, means sporting cell. This is a common sustandicular term, is a very common all over the histology. Any sporting cell, any connective tissue sporting cells, or any sporting cells in epithelium is known as sustandicular cells. But they are more commonly known as Sertoli cells or nurse cells. Okay, what really happening here? So the point about Sertoli cell, come back here. I was saying that this spermatozoa have to travel light, like a boy who is chasing the girl. Okay, so what really happening? From lumen, they will go into straight tubule, straight tube to ratty testis, afferent ducts. Epididymis is the organ which stores spermatozoa. So up to here, this sperm is not fully matured. So maturation of sperm is also take place in
epididymis.
Okay, what really happen? If there is the ejaculation, if there is excitement, this sperm will from epididymis go to the vas deferens via copulatory organ penis, via urethra. They will be introduced into the vagina of female reproductive tract. From there, they still have lot of journey. From vagina, cervix, cervix to uterus, uterus to uterine horn, uterine horn to oviduct. Oviduct where they will find ova. So this is a lot of journey. This how you can get a proper girl. You have to travel a lot. You have to work hard. You have to make some modifications. Earn money, have a big house, have a big car. Listen. So why we are tracking this journey? Because, listen again carefully. Because this structure, you know, these modifications, if you have a big house, if you have a big car, girls will come easily. So instead, this sperm have what? They have acrosome. They have tail. They have lot of mitochondria and consigned into the one regions. So for this travel, they need a flagellum for movement. And for movement, they need what?
Energy.
So for movement, for being motile, they first they have tail. Then that moment when they need energy, they have
mitochondria.
Is the powerhouse of cell. So that's why in any, you know, spermatozoa, below this nucleus or head, a core, a midpoint, you will find lot of mitochondria here. There is another story how they will come here and accumulate here, how they change their shape. This is a long story. This happening in spermiogenesis. But finally, at least when they reached ova, still ova is not willing to meet. Still ova is not willing to meet. Finally, they need what? I need a good profile. I need something to introduce. So they will have finally acrosome. Maybe the father of girl is agree, okay? So this acrosome will damage the ova, will make ask the ova, please meet with sperm. So this acrosome also, point is that this acrosome is developing during spermiogenesis. This acrosome is developing during spermiogenesis. So again, and finally, if you are looking into the functional histology of testes, I would tell you very simply, we have what? Testes are a network of tubules. Testes are the network of tubules. If you go inside the testes, you will find testes are covered by a thin connective tissue capsule. Inside have many lobes. Lobes have what? Seminiferable tubules. Seminiferable tubules have germinal epithelium. Have? Which is structurally stratified epithelium. That germinal epithelium have two type of cells. Germ cell and? Sertoli cells. These germ cell and Sertoli cells and one cell which are in the interstitium outside of the seminiferal tubule leading cell. These togetherly working for the procedure of spermatogenesis. They are togetherly working to perform the spermatogenesis. This spermatogenesis actually a cell differentiation and cell division. This spermatogenesis is actually cell differentiation and cell division. Here you will find first mitosis, then meiosis, and finally cell differentiation are the another sense of modification of spermatid into the spermatozoa. So if somebody asks you what is the main function of testes, they are, in the case of human beings, if the adult is healthy, normal physiology, in a 1 second, adult testes is producing 1,001 k spermatozoa. 1 k spermatozoa. And the second function of testes is they are producing some hormones which help in spermatogenesis and also help to the develop male sex character. Like testosterone, they also help to develop the male. Okay? Thank you very much.